January 21st, 2018. The Pryor Trust gas well, located in Pittsburg County, Oklahoma. Crew members from the Patterson-UTI Drilling Company had been drilling the well for over a week under the oversight of Red Mountain Operating, LLC. At 3:36 p.m., the Patterson crew stopped drilling. They did so because they planned to remove the drill pipe from the well and change the drill bit. At 6:48 p.m., crew members started to remove the drill pipe from the wellbore. During this operation, called tripping, mud is pumped into the well with the intent to replace the volume of drill pipe being removed. This is meant to prevent gas from flowing into the well. The well was a horizontal well with a vertical section and a lateral section. By 10:30 p.m., the end of the drill pipe had been removed from the lateral section and reached the top of the curve in the well. The Patterson crew then pumped what is known as a pill of weighted fluid into the well, intended to prevent gas from flowing into the well below the pill. By 1:12 a.m. the next day, January 22nd, the crew started to remove the drill pipe from the vertical section of the well. But drilling crew members found that the drill pipe being removed from the vertical section had not drained and still contained mud. The Patterson crew attempted to pump a weighted slug of mud into the drill pipe to push the mud out of the drill pipe, but this was not successful as the pipe was plugged. The crew continued working, and by 6:10 a.m., the drill pipe and bottom hole assembly, including the drill bit, were completely removed, and the blind rams on the well's blowout preventer were closed. At 7:57 a.m., the blind rams were reopened so that a new bottom hole assembly could be lowered into the well. At 8:09 a.m., mud was pumped through the bottom hole assembly to test the new equipment. Between 7:57 a.m. and 8:35 a.m., while the drilling crew was testing the equipment, the drilling rig's mud pits gained 107 barrels of mud. Mud pit gains are an indication there could be a gas influx in the well, as mud is pushed out of the well and into the mud pits. The CSB obtained and is analyzing data that shows conditions existed that could have allowed gas to enter into the well during the tripping operation. At 8:35 a.m., with testing complete, the bottom hole assembly was removed from the well. At that time, a crew member observed mud flowing up out of the open blowout preventer stack. A minute later, at 8:36 a.m., mud blew upwards out of the well. The gas and mud from the well ignited, causing a large fire. Five people were killed. The blowout continued for hours until a well control services company was able to successfully shut in the well around 4 p.m.